Hello. I'm on the wrong side. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Really? So I've been super busy lately on a project I can't show you, but it occurred to me that I haven't put a video out in a couple weeks and I felt bad about it. So let me show you something small that I did to a recent piece of vintage machinery I bought here off of Craigslist. I'm out here freezing for you. Look what I picked up. This is a crazy old 1940's Delta DP220 drill press. Very happy about this. Came with a big old honking AC motor. And while it worked fine, my new obsession is to convert all these old tools over to DC motors. Why would you want a DC motor, you say? Let me tell you. With the old motor on here, I basically had high speed forward. Now, I could change the configuration of the pulleys up here, and that would give me higher or lower speed, but it's a huge pain in the butt to try to move the pulleys around, move them up, move them down, and this one's, oh, there that is. I was wondering where that was. Anyhow, put a DC motor on it, put a DC motor controller on it, cleaned it up as best I could, put a V-belt on it, took a table that I had on my old tabletop drill press, put it on here instead. Now I have a super nice old school drill press with forward, reverse, full variable speed, pause, and jog. Let's play with it. Hello, can you go? Hello, can you go? This is about as low as it'll go. It's completely useless, but as low as it'll go. I got it down to 48, 49. All right, now let's do it as fast as we can. And to be frank, this kind of scares me. In summary, get yourself some old steel. Put a new DC motor on it. You can rip them out of a treadmill for like free. Put a controller on there. You can either buy one of these pre-made for about $100, or you can make them yourself out of an old MC60 treadmill controller. You can buy those on eBay as well. I'll have links to all this stuff below so you can make it yourself if you want to, and convert one of your old vintage tools at home.
I know, you probably want more detail, but this is just a high-level view to show you what I did. In the future, I will take one of my other vintage tools and convert that one to DC as well, and really get into it with you and show you the details about how I did it. So, stay tuned for next time, and thanks for watching!